resolution introduced here in the legislature would allow Utah to get in on potentially billions of dollars in infrastructure to build a commuter rail network.
There is going to be money coming for infrastructure across the country. We should be at the table when it comes to being the crossroads of the West.
Senate Minority Whip Luz Escamilla has introduced a resolution to push for commuter rail options across the state.
It's really about just transportation, getting us to the next level. We are growing as a state. We need those type of infrastructures in our state.
This would allow Utah to push for potentially billions in infrastructure spending for a commuter rail system. These would not be trains like Front Runner or tracks, but expansion of commuter rail like Amtrak. High-speed bullet trains are also very expensive. The federal government has already approved infrastructure spending, but Utah needs to act.
It's important because we are anticipating for Congress to make a large pot of infrastructure funding available probably sometime in February.
Mike Christensen is with the Utah Rail Passengers Association, a group that's been lobbying for this. He says you could see train lines from Ogden to Cedar City and Provo to Green River, putting people closer to tourism hotspots like Moab and St. George. Right now, the rail lines don't go any further than that.
It's relatively quick and simple to get passenger rail service on existing tracks, but it's going to take a whole lot more to get new rail into places that don't have it. But yeah, St. George is very much on the top of the list of places that we need to connect to. And actually, Washington County is one of the most populated counties in the nation that doesn't have a rail connection.
Senator Escamilla says eventually it could go beyond that.
Connecting us with other states as well, that's why it's encouraging the regional approach, which have been very successful for other parts of the country.
Now the resolution has just been introduced. It'll get a hearing in the coming weeks. On the Hill, Ben Winslow, Fox 13 News, Utah.